Dennis, how did I solve this?
I don't know. You made it. Buy a windmill. Oh, see, there's the floating island that he left. Oh. There's Asus working on his machine again.
Right. Dennis, I have an idea. Now we're going to add the wings. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
Alright. So they're going to be very small wings.
Why didn't we do this in UHC? We could have won.
That's going to be the next boat escape. Alright.
Welcome to another episode of Hunting for a Nutshapple and answering random questions because... I'm still here in the mineshaft. Decided to do another one. Kill this skeleton. Hopefully find a nutshapel, which I probably won't. So let's just kick off where we left in the last episode, just answering some more random questions. Learning about Flux, or something like that. What's down here? It's a zombie and a creeper and a zombie and a creeper and a skeleton. Where's the Enderman? So the first question that came up on this random question generator for this episode is, what was the biggest life change you've gone through? And that could be a lot of things, actually. Oh, hey creeper. One of the things that changed my life a lot was dealing with stress a few years ago. If you don't know anything about stress, it's something that usually will never you will never get fully over it. You will just learn to live with a lot of stuff. So you get better at it by time, and eventually you might be lucky enough that it will mostly go away, or all of it will go away. But there's definitely things that you still have to be careful about. For instance, I used to live in Copenhagen, which is the biggest city here in Denmark. And after dealing with stress, I had to move. I couldn't deal with so many people all the time. I couldn't dealing with being around people that much anymore. Like, I've always been a person. I've always been introvert, I guess. But having to deal with that is not something I hope I can do it someday and not have it bother me, but like being around people, that many people, for a long period of time, I have a hard time dealing with it. And I have a hard time dealing with noise and stuff. But I managed to like work it out so it's tolerable, at least for shorter periods. And hopefully one day it will change. I would personally love to move back to Copenhagen one day, because I love the city. It's an awesome city, and kind of hinders me in this for many reasons. Oh, hey guy. And there's a lot of other things as well. There's many life, like, things that changes your life. I would say actually, like, the job I have now, due to the environment we're in, my closest boss, my colleagues has changed me a lot. It's helped me a lot going further and stuff, and really it makes me enjoy my life at work, which is not always something it's not something that always happens, and it's not everybody that's so lucky they can enjoy their job and enjoy their work. Unfortunately, they should, but it's unfortunate, the fact of life. Well, this is bad. So yeah, that was definitely a huge. That was some moments that has changed my life for sure. It's been obviously there's been many other things that has done things to my life, both positive and negative. But yeah, I would say dealing with stress was definitely one of the hardest parts, and one that changed me a lot. Yeah, let's move on to the next question. What food do you like to snack on? I like different stuff. I like gummies, and I like licorice. I can't say it right now. The things Americans don't understand, we like in Scandinavia. Also, really like different kinds of nuts, like peanuts and pistachios and stuff like that. I've been here before. I can't hit that bat. Oh, there we go. Let's go back here, I guess. What's the longest time you've gone without showering? I don't know. Some days. Not that long. Maybe. I don't know. I would guess. I guess there's probably been time where it's been like four or five days. Certainly not longer than that. Which is better, being the boss or the employee? Yeah. I don't think. Like, for me, I don't necessarily think I could be a boss. I don't necessarily have the personality to it. I'm a great secondhand man. But while I'm curious about, like, being a boss, I don't necessarily think I would be good at it. I'm not gonna say it's worse, but there's a lot of pressure that comes with being a boss, and it's not necessarily always worth the pay. And sometimes, especially if you're not, like, if you're not the top boss of a company, you sometimes have to deal with some assholes making silly decisions, and you have to follow them and make your employees follow those lines. And there's a lot of responsibility, and basically in most jobs I would say that if you're a boss, well, you're never truly off work, which could be an issue for some people. But it depends what you do, I guess. Like I said previously, I would kind of like being self-employed at some point if I could figure out the right thing to do it with. And there obviously is a lot of work involved with that. I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing if you if you're passionate about what you're doing. I can't remember how I came here. What was the least favorite job you had? Like, with the exception of like, for a few months when I was young, I delivered, like, not newspapers, but like commercials and stuff, kind of like, I guess like paperboy stuff. I didn't enjoy that. I did some. It basically counts as sales work. I'll tell that right away. I hate anything that has to do with sales. And I'll never work with anything related to that again. But yeah, I had a job when I was in school at some point where we had to call out and try to book phone meetings for insurance company. I kind of hated that. And it's just, it doesn't fit my personality, basically. And actually, the closest boss I had knew that, and he knew that I wasn't a bad worker, it was just not something for me. And we pretty much agreed upon that, and later on I actually ended up working at a different position at a job full-time and worked there for years and stuff. So it wasn't all bad, something good came out of it. Holy crap, there's a lot of creepers. Are they all dead now? So yeah, that was, I guess, yeah, that was the worst job I had. But I never really worked like something. I never worked like at a store or at a fast food restaurant or anything like that. Which I imagine would be so much worse. To some degree, at least equally. I worked at a cafe, where I was like kind of like a bartender, I guess, and like just part time while I was in school, and that was pretty decent, even for and kind of introverted person like myself. I had a lot of fun, a lot of good colleagues, and except for a few busy hours, it wasn't that bad. And we drank a lot of beer, basically, on the house. What is your favorite season? Rabbit season. No. I would say probably spring, followed by the fall. I don't like the summer because I don't like the heat. I don't really like winter that much. I prefer, to some degree, I prefer winter over summer, because I can stand with the cold a lot more than I can stand with the heat. Stupid chests. So I'm not that much of a... What is this book? Oh, I'll take that. So, yeah, I guess, like, spring is, like, a middle thing between, like, the summer... Well, it's a decent period, and usually it's more... It's a bit more refreshing than like fall, where you got the summer and it can often like be raining and stuff, and a bit of boring weather sometimes. So I guess I would say spring. What was the last gift you received? The gift of laughter. No. Oh. Hello, guy. The last gift I received. Well, I guess the last gifts I received was Christmas presents. Right? And I got more than one Christmas present. what did I get for Christmas? I can't even remember now. Got some, I guess, not that interesting things, like gloves. And what the hell did I get? I got a rice cooker. I'm pretty happy about that. That's an amazing tool for making food. So yeah, that was one of the things. I can't really remember what else I got. What do you do in your spare time? I play games. Mostly. And other stuff. Not too much at the moment. Love to hang out with friends and stuff and things like that. But currently I don't do too much, but that's basically because of this damn mono shit. Would I do other stuff? I guess I would. Feels like so long ago by now. Hang out, talk with people, I guess. Do you like to cook? I do like to cook. When I feel like it. I'm a pretty decent chef. I can make some pretty decent food. Describe your perfect man or woman. Well, the man is easy. That's just me. Obviously I'm the perfect man. Perfect woman. Well, first of all, I have an issue with things you call perfect. I don't believe in that. But I guess the perfect woman would be basically just be somebody that respects you for who you are, that loves you for who you are, and is a good friend. And doesn't play games and stuff. I'm not talking about video games, but what did you have for lunch today? I already said that in either the last episode or this episode. What are some things you shouldn't say at work? Yeah, I kind of should be able to answer that. I'm very strongly opinionated, and I try to express my real opinion as much as possible. And you can't always do that in all jobs, and you shouldn't always just say what's on your mind. You have to be professional about it. And I think you should be, for the most part, be honest, but you should also be thinking about other people's feelings. If you have a lot of bad things to say about your job, stuff that's going on, you should probably consider if you're in the right place. But of course, you basically shouldn't tell your boss or your colleagues to go fuck themselves, or you shouldn't tell them necessarily that they're doing a horrible job. You should help them, especially when it goes to colleagues, try to help them improve, try to say it in a nice way. Don't be an asshole about it, because you don't know what's going on in their life. And sometimes people forget that there's reasons why people are like they are. Just be nice to people. But you should always, always question what you're doing. If you're doing it right for yourself, and if you disagree with how your work is, if you feel like that you're that you can't be yourself at work, if you feel like you can't represent yourself at work, that you don't believe in the stuff you work with, you can do that for a limited period, but eventually it will break you down. And you can't change the world alone. You can fight it. You should probably give it a chance. If you want to change something at your work, try to speak your opinion. But you have to be realistic and see if things don't happen the way you think they should. Can't keep to trying to change him, especially if you work in a big company, because that will eventually hurt you more than it will hurt the work place, because they will continue their ways. And if you just continue with following their line of work with something you basically disagree with, it will lead to bad things for you. And it's something worth remembering. But you shouldn't give up from day one necessarily, if you see a potential, if you see a possibility. But you should speak your mind. Just do it in the right manner. And maybe it's something the people at the job hadn't thought about. It's possible. And maybe you will help bring a change for the better. But you can't change the world alone. You can't change the world for everyone. Sometimes just have to realize that the workplace is maybe not for you, and you have to find something else. At the end of the day, you're supposed to be enjoying yourself, supposed to have a good life. Money isn't everything. As long as you can live a decent life, doesn't matter how much money you got. And that's something I would say is worth remembering. So yeah, that's my two cents at least. If I could eat one thing for the rest of my life, what would it be? Pineapple. I would hate just eating one thing for the rest of my life. Oh, there's a chest. Could this be the magical hidden nutshell? No. Not even close. That's sad. I think what is that, like a 0.1% of finding a nutshell in a chest or something? Yeah. Probably not in my lifetime. I heard goddamn the killer told me he found one in a chest. And I can't believe that people haven't, like, when they heard the notch apples getting removed, that they didn't craft a lot of the notch apples. It's kind of strange to me. I have seen somebody with a chest with two notch apples in him, but I don't know who the chest belongs to. I'm not sure if it's still there. But then again, like, I would imagine that people would have crafted a lot of nut chapels, but at the same time, I just remembered the other day that, well, I didn't go ahead and craft a lot of bows with mending and on infinity, which you can't craft now. If I'd done that, I would be future proof. Now I'm not. While I don't imagine that I will lose a lot of bows, it would be nice to have a few more extras. I certainly broke that chest. So I guess, well, it's something you don't really think about. And I'm right in the same boat as them. Do you follow your heart or your head? No, not chapel. What do I follow? A bit of both, I'd say. I probably follow my head a bit more than I follow my heart. Which probably isn't that great. It's probably better doing it the other way around, maybe. But I'm a thinker. I think a lot about things. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that would be the right way to say it. What are you carrying? A sword? Well, you are a blacksmith, maybe. This mineshaft goes on and on forever. Usually don't find that many diamonds around these mine shafts, and this is no different. I'm probably not at diamond level even. I think I have some ghost blocks around me. What is one thing that you would like to change about the world? Just one thing. Well, if I can only change one thing, I would change the fact I would have people care more about each other and have more respect for each other. That seems very, very unlikely, though. Because the rich cares about getting richer and getting more powerful, and they can be as corrupt as they want, and nothing ever happens about it. Do you believe in faith? No. Are you a risk taker? What is the biggest risk you have ever taken? I'm not really a risk taker. I wish I was more of a risk taker, but I'm not.
biggest risk I've ever taken.
No clue. Absolutely no clue. I don't think I've taken too many big risks in my life. And it's kind of a shame. If I could suggest things to people, I would suggest people taking some risks. It often pays off way better. I just like being secure, and it's very hard to take risks if you want to be secure at the same time. It doesn't really fit. What? Stupid bat. But yeah, risks. With the risk comes the reward, as the saying goes. Do you prefer a quiet night at home or going out to a big party? That's a pretty easy one. I prefer a quiet night at home. I basically never prefer a big party. I can enjoy parties. I'm better with people one-on-one though, or in a small group. So I certainly would prefer, and I'm very, very much a person who needs my quiet time. So especially, I enjoy being with people, but I enjoy my quiet time as well. So that's a very easy answer for me. If you could choose to live, if you choose any era to live in, what would it be? I don't know. Honestly, sometimes I would love to live in a simpler time. But what is a simpler time, really? And has there really been a simpler time? I don't know. Do you prefer to travel or stay at home? I probably prefer to stay at home, but I would like to travel a lot more. So yeah, well, I can see by my recording that I'm running a bit long, so I'm gonna end the episode here. Thank you for watching, if you're still watching this, whatever this is. Am I gonna do another one? I think I might do another one. So hopefully this isn't too boring. Hopefully it's good and something educational, or good advice, or just a rambling idiot. The last one is probably true. So I'll see you in the next one.